My understanding is society only has two things. We have our people and we have our land. When we develop solar arrays, we need to keep our land functional because that's part of our society. Traditional solar installations, the land is a detriment because it potentially can grow vegetation that might shade the solar panels. And if it shades the panels, then that's less electricity it produces. So they hire people to go in and mow it or spray that land and keep that land degraded over time. A different way of doing it is by elevating the panels so that you can have solar above agriculture. Agrivoltaics is agriculture and photovoltaics smashed together to make agrivoltaics. The solar panels provide that shade, that microclimate for crops to be able to grow in, and it makes it easier for people to be within that space or for tractors to be within that space. Agrivoltaics has so many wins involved with it.
We are seeing a mutually beneficial relationship between the solar panels and the vegetation. As temperatures get too hot, many plants shut down their photosynthetic activities throughout the middle part of the day. The partial shade from the panels allows that photosynthesis to continue occurring throughout the growing day. The plants actually create a cooler microclimate underneath the panels. That cooler microclimate creates higher efficiencies and higher output. The cooler conditions underneath the panels lead to less evaporation of water from the soil. That allows us to reduce the amount of supplemental water we give for irrigation, which in some cases could be half as much water to achieve the same yields. So what this means is that instead of vegetation serving as a barrier to solar development, it actually can lead to lower O&M costs for managing, as well as higher panel efficiencies leading to more clean energy production.
Jack Solar Garden is the largest commercial research site for agrivoltaics in the U.S. 3,276 panels, producing enough clean energy for about 300 homes in our area.
We're growing at least 15 different varieties of crops, everything from salad greens to cooking greens to root veggies. We were really excited to make use of the space under the solar panels because it has historically just been sitting there unused, and to be able to work in the shade in the middle of the day. I think that could have really long-term benefits for farm worker health. We feel like there's so many benefits. Reduced water, the plants will do better because of the microclimate created by the panels. The farmers have a better time because they're not in the sun all day. That we're using the land for food production instead of it just sitting there vacant. And it'll all be funneled back to the local community, including donations to food pantries, CSA programs, and also some farmers markets. It might be win-win-win.
We want to show our community that there's a different way that we can have solar energy being produced across our country, that it doesn't have to be how it's always been.
The potential is boundless. Everywhere people live, they need energy and they need food.
The insights we're gaining here will inform development not only in Colorado, but also throughout the country and throughout the world.
We need bigger change, and we need it from our policymakers, we need it from the solar developers, we need it from landowners.